ma'am, I get really affected when I come across something wrong, like a narrow-mindedness of people. I mean, I try to take a stand always, but at times it drains my energy and I feel very helpless. Rupali, I think one of the most important things for all of us to understand is that God has made no mistakes, okay? Everyone is born because that's how they are meant to be. If God wanted all of us to be open-minded, He would have made us like that. If God wanted all of us to be narrow-minded, He would have made us like that. Didn't He do that to the animals? He wanted every animal to have the same value system, the same core personality. So He made sure all tigers eat deer. Okay? Not some tigers eat deer, some tigers eat grass, some tigers eat elephant, some tigers eat... No. It's one kind. What He did with the human is He said, you know what, I'm going to create different. Every human is going to be different from the other. And let's see what the world looks like when everybody is different. You know what's happened? We have used our intelligence to judge others. When we saw different, instead of appreciating and respecting that difference, we started to go, mine is better than yours. You know, you are like this, I am like this, I am better than you. And then it irritates us. So you want the other person to become more like you. What if you had to become a lot more accepting, Rupali? What if you had to walk around life saying, you know what? I was meant to live this way. You were meant to live that way. I can respect you. Can you respect me? You know, the more you grow, evolve spiritually, the thought is not, I am unique. The thought becomes that we are actually all the same. The same electricity that is energy force in your soul is the same electricity in my soul. So for me to think that I am better than you is just my ego talking. We are all the same, all on our journey, doing whatever it is that we are supposed to grow our souls. Some people will grow their soul in this lifetime, some will grow it in their next lifetime. The picture is so long, we cannot take 5 minutes of the picture and decide who the villain is, who the hero is, who the this thing is. We don't know what happened to them in their previous lives. We don't know where they are supposed to go in their future lives. Maybe this is the quality they need to build that you are not right now feeling attracted to. So Rupali, in every way, rather to every single person who's on this live today, I'm going to start to ask you, can you evolve yourself to a place where you can respect the opposite of you? You know, I don't like swearing. When I see someone swearing for one second, I cringe, right? But you know what? If that's how they grew up, if that's how they were taught to speak, if that's how they feel they show love, then let that be their way. Who am I to judge and decide what is wrong, what is right, unless it's criminal by law? Okay, like unless someone's harming someone, which I know for sure is wrong, I'm not going to judge someone for their personality because God wanted each one of us to be different. Okay, and God wanted all of us to grow into people where we can start to love and respect other people even when they don't have the same thought. Same thought though is so easy to love. There it doesn't take any effort. Then what kind of a loving person are you if the only person you can love is your kind? Loving person you are when you can love the opposite. When you can love people who hurt you, because you know hurt people hurt people. So they are hurting, they are crying for love. That's why they are hurting people. And here you are giving them hatred. Okay, so see Rupali, if any of this helps you, my darling, I understand where you're coming from. It's not like I don't know, but I'd love for you to look at it from this perspective and start to open yourself up to, you know, instead of feeling drained or, you know, disgusted, I would love it if you start to go, God, one more piece, different, wow, amazing. You know, don't we go into a potter's shop and realize with the same clay he can make 100 different varieties of things. Yes, a few look more beautiful than the other to us, and a few may look more beautiful to your friend, and it may be totally different, but how does it matter? The potter has done its job, and our job is to, okay, connect with the ones we love and disconnect with the ones we don't, but we can still respect them. We don't need to take them and break them, correct? So see if any of that helps you.